Hello, welcome to this video. Ray Lear. My opponent is there. Nope. Okay, let's go for my. I really have to check my statistics there once. Probably have never ever played a draw with the same-ish. Maybe some perpetuals or so, but check. It's just such a sharp opening. That's one of the older ways to battle this. Back to Botvinnik, Capablanca, 1936. Is it 1936? I think it is. 38? Something like that. Yeah, I'm going for an e4 break here in the center. Got some experience with those positions. This is why I played it quite quickly. Idea is bishop b2 and then e4. Currently e4 is not possible because of that weak d4 pawn. Okay, that is normally a huge strategic mistake. I'm kind of okay, he's not worried at all. Bishop g5 was even stronger. I have to slow down. I mean, I really have to. If they play such rubbish, I have to think for a moment and then totally refute it. That is really bad. Yeah, bishop g5 was a lot stronger, a lot stronger. I mean, this is still terrible for black, but I could have played the other line, and it would have been more convincing, absolutely. Yeah, I'm winning the exchange here, at least. Okay, so I think I take here first. Okay, I think I can take on... Wait, let's check this quickly. I go bishop e3. No, that doesn't work at all. I have bishop f2 at the end. Yeah, so I can do this first and then take one of the rooks. Knight d e5, d takes e5, d4, I've got bishop f2. Doesn't work at all. Now c4 is just a strategic nightmare, that move. Okay, so now I can trade queens, and I probably have to anyway, so let's do that. And then grab the exchange. Okay, at the moment, I don't have to take it right away, but I wonder if there is some point in delaying that. Rook c1 is an interesting move. So that he cannot move the knight there. What is his move actually against that? Knight d4? Wait, knight d4. Knight d4. Rook takes c8. Knight e2, that's actually playable. Amazing. So... I just wonder if I have something that is more precise there than just grabbing on e8. Rook c1 knight d4 is kind of a miracle move, but if it works, it works. Okay, so let's grab. So let's do this. Knight a5. This bishop. Here I've got bishop d2. That should be quite clear. Rook b8 was stronger. Rook b2 is probably the same thing. Okay, that was his idea, but I think I can get this now. A pin now, come on.
Black resigns.
Yeah, the thing is, c4 is just not a playable move. I think it's just that's just not good at all. That gives me, I don't know, I don't get it, why to play that kind of move, because it's well known since like 1925 or so, 1930, that you cannot do this with e4 unless you have a super clear quick counterplay, and black doesn't have any. So e4, and here I went e5. Maybe it's the best move, but I played it too quickly because I wanted to just punish that stuff. But I should have at least considered bishop g5. I'm not sure if it is really stronger, but this threat is pretty substantial. Okay, the engine gives h6. Maybe e5 is better, actually, what I did, but I mean, this is pretty awful, the knight coming to d6. Yeah, that shouldn't work at all. Takes. Yeah, bishop e3 I think is important. If I take here, he's got knight d4. So this, and now he cannot do anything like that because I have this move. That's still important to have. This. I took it. Yeah, I mean, this would have been nice, but he's got this trick. I just took it, and then rook here. I was thinking this, but I think it does win as well. Can I do this? Knight c4, rook b3. Okay, that's not entirely clear. Yeah, okay, that should win for white, but it's not entirely clear. The engine wants to do this here, and now just back. Yeah, this is better, of course, intending bishop e1. That's good technical play. Yeah. So this is the best, probably here. And now this is important. Yeah, very important, actually, that I can take here because of the back rank. And now just this move is strong. I'm getting a second pawn. Okay, it wasn't that easy technically. The move c4 is something that black has to be very, very cautious about, because it gives white free rein in the center. And his play, it takes a few moves until it is substantial, and I'm already breaking through in the center. a5, I just wonder, maybe bishop g5 is better. I don't know, I really don't know. The engine gives this here, and now rook b1, funny enough. Well, that's not convincing. I think this is better. What I did is better. I mean, black can try to not lose the exchange with some move. Rook e6, for example. It's still not entirely clear. Yeah, that's not clear at all. Maybe that isn't so bad. I mean, c4 usually is just utter rubbish, and maybe here it is not one of the worst instances of that. Still bishop g5. I don't know. This is also a line that the engine is giving, just taking that pawn. But that is not too convincing, I think. Okay, maybe it wasn't completely bad, c4, at this particular moment. But in general, I'm very skeptical about this kind of advance in this structure. Okay, thanks for watching.